is this tax deductible? Like if I do income tax?
This is tax deductible, yes.
Okay, cool. So I'll do 20 now.
So I'm gonna give you some time to do that.
If the same bank is giving $7, like you lose $20?
You actually, yes, you get the same benefits.
It's just what you wanna do.
Yes, it's just what you wanna do. No more benefits, no more, no more, no less. Now, as you fill that out, I will start to talk about the next page. Everybody heard about common sense immigration reform? President Obama's put that on the table for folks to, for people to have support immigration reform. It is the reform to make sure that everybody can be in this country, and we want everybody to pay their fair share of taxes. We want everybody to get their fair share of all the benefits that are going on. We don't want people to be in the country legally. I'd rather you be looking than get us. I'd rather us know what's going on.
Okay.
because up, they started the Timecard Training up north, and there were so many issues. So our president said, hey, let's jump the gun. They only had 70,000 people up north. We have 180,000. Imagine if we don't do this and people don't get the training. How bad it's going to be. So, again, we want to make sure this, if you want to volunteer help, and I really need help in Vietnamese, Tagalog, and things like that, I need help with those languages. We need to reach out to our members and make sure we're a very diverse union. We need to make sure we talk to all of our members, whether Black, Latino, Spanish, Chinese, Mandarin, Vietnamese, Tagalog. We need to talk to our members. The Dignity Pledge again, which is the last page, the second to the last page. It's just you signing the page and saying you support the issue. That's all. Any questions? Now, everybody has a pen, because we're going to start to get to the good part. Please pay attention. It is very important. Miguel and Florence are going to give the training on the timesheets. Take your time. Learn as much as you can. We don't have any place to go. We have all night. If you don't get it, stick around. We'll help you out. And guys, I say this because of this. I'm sad. It took me three times. Three trips. Saturday, we'll be back here at 10 o'clock doing it all over again. This is not the first time. We're going to do this until we get it right. But we've really downsized it, and we think we've got it to the point where we can give you this training. But everybody needs to pitch in, take their time, suck it, soak it all in, and learn. We can do it in the next hour. It can happen. It has happened. It will happen. And we'll make it happen. But we can only do it together. Okay. So please give everybody your attention, please. I call them my love folk. All right? Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
And make sure you guys turn all the cards. Can we pick those up right now?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good luck.
establish a timely check. You know, you receive your check every 2 weeks, and it's in order to avoid those late checks. We don't want that to keep happening anymore, right? Every 2 weeks? Yeah. Next person. Oh, I'll read it. All California counties will use the same computer system. So everyone in California, every county in California is using the same computer system. So now, the IHSS time sheet will be different. Obviously, we're all here for that. And you can no longer submit.
Let's submit the information to read.
Oh, okay. Yep. All right, then. What else wants to read?
First time champion, read on.
All right. The third.
Rancho Dominguez now.
Yeah? You can no longer submit it. Some people would walk it in, some people would just mail it into that office. No longer to that office.
You're talking too fast. Slow it down.
You can't hear you, man. You're talking too fast. You need to slow down.
It'll no longer be to your local office. It'll go to Chico, California. And your tax sheet will have an envelope with that address. So you don't have to worry about it, okay?
Even if your time sheet is late, you would still send it to Chico. It would no longer go to your local office at all.
Yeah. Where's Chico at? I never heard of Chico.
Where is Chico?
I never heard of Chico.
Okay, you call it Chico?
Chino.
You call it Chico, but they call it Chico.
All right. You get on a plane and fly up north and get off the bus and walk to Chico.
East Bay.
It's a small town. Giant Hewlett-Packard computer in one college. That's all there is there.
Yeah, it's a college town. Who wants to read the next bullet point? Lovely, yes.
I'll do it.
All right.
Your consumer case number will change.
Louder,
your consumer's case number will change.
So that number that has 19 in front of it for your consumer,
right.
It will no longer be started with 19, not that I know of anyway, but it will change.
Okay.
So you might want to tell your consumers about that. Their number is going to change.
Would there be on your timesheet like the original number they're using now, 19? Okay, then.
So they only
flip the page over.
Girl, page 3.
This is a smaller print of what the new timesheet would look like. This is the time of the timesheet, okay? So who would like to read one of the arrows? The first one on the left, thank you.
Yes.
24.5.
Excuse me.
It used to tell you what you give her.
Yeah.
1.1, is that the one that?
So, luckily, and her question is, she was asking, how do you turn the decimal into?
Okay, they said you got 23.1.
Yeah, so your hours are coming in as decimals, they're gonna change it for you to hours and minutes. So, that's a good thing, right? They're gonna change it for us, it's just up to us to make sure we divide it in half.
Okay, that's.
In other words, they are converting that point one into actual minutes.
Okay.
But, and. That's what you're sending out.
You're sending this out?
Yeah.
Oh, so this is the back of this?
No, it's up front. I'm going to go to the back right now, but that's what you're keeping up there.
You're going to keep this in
position. Just you keep it attached. Right?
I'm keeping this?
Yes, and you're sending out the bottom part. Because you want the machine to read your hours, right?
But you say you got to write, like, elementary school.
Yeah, and we'll give you guys an exercise for that, too.
Elementary school, no.
So her question was, what do you do with the top part? The bottom part.
Regular.
The bottom.